So what is the best all-around camera for YouTube and vlogging? Well, it could be the Canon M50. We've been testing the camera out, and in this video, I'm gonna be doing my full review of this camera and sharing some of my favorite features coming up. Hey, what's up? Sean here with Think Media, bringing you the best tips and tools for building your influence with online video. And on this channel, we do a lot of strategy videos as well as tech gear reviews, just like this one. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And hey, at any point during the video, check out show notes and links in the description below. We'll list out all of the gear and accessories that we use, as well as bonus tips. Let's jump into the video. So first of all, let's start off with just the build quality and design of the Canon M50. Now, that's probably one of my favorite things about this camera is really its size and the layout of everything they've put in the camera. You know, it comes in white and it also comes in black styling. Both look really cool, really chic. You have that flip screen to selfie. Now, coming out with the flip screen to the side of the camera like this was the first time that Canon's done this in their mirrorless line, which is huge because in the past, on like maybe the M6 and some of the M100, the screen would flip up, blocking you from having a mic on top of the camera. So having the flip screen to the side, very angle LCD screen, is huge. The camera is very light, and that's why this is a huge contender for a great vlogging camera. So the fact that it's small and portable while still having interchangeable lenses, not being too heavy, is really amazing. I love the rubberized grip right here, as well as even a little bit of the rubberized grip on the back there. White or black, it has this kind of a nice grippy feel to it, as well as just the body styling in general. One of the things I've always loved about Canon is their thoughtfulness with each button, each dial, the toggle wheels. And if you're used to their user interface, it's a great benefit if you've been using it for a while, or if you're new to cameras, it's also really great for beginners and just getting started. Now, at the time of shooting this video, the body itself is available for right around $780 here in the US, and if you add a lens to that, it goes up to right around $900 here in the US. So a great value, and we'll talk about some of the features coming up in this video. Additionally, the battery is an LPE 12 battery. And now this isn't Canon's most powerful battery, but Canon's known for pretty good battery life. I would recommend picking up an extra battery for your camera because especially if you're gonna be shooting video, you're gonna want more batteries anyways. So now that we've talked about the exterior of this camera, let's talk about some of the features and what you have inside. One of my favorite things is that this is a APS-C sensor. So the sensor is very large for great photos, great in low light, great video quality, and it's over 24 megapixels. So this is also a great camera for photos, even though a lot of people will be picking it up for video. Now we already talked about the touchscreen, but one thing that I love about it is that it's responsive and bright. Like where you touch is exactly what it reacts to, and it's very visible, whether shooting inside or even outdoors. Sometimes in outdoors, if you're in direct sunlight, you usually, any camera, you need to kind of shield it or be in the shade, but it's definitely brighter than other LCD screens that I've looked at, produces a great image so you can make sure you get that perfect photo or that perfect video clip every time. Now the Canon M50 is the first camera to incorporate the DIGIC 8 processor. And with a new processor, really just means new improved speeds, a little bit improved image quality, potentially better low light performance, and really just the speed of the processor to support all of the features that they've packed in there. And one of those updated features is the fact that you can do 10 photos continuous shooting in photo mode, which is cool if you want to capture some movement or some sports. And that new processor also supports improved dual pixel autofocus. Now, we should pause here for a bit because that is one of the most important features of this camera. The autofocus on Canon cameras during video and even for photos is really world class and industry leading. So that means when you are filming yourself with say face tracking or you're vlogging, it's gonna track your face, keep you tack sharp and focused. And from our test, we didn't see it hunting for focus or really looking around for focus. When shooting in the standard 1080p shooting modes, whether 30 frames or 60 frames a second, the autofocus is amazing. And that new processor and dual pixel also supports more autofocus points. Some lenses even support 143 autofocus points if you have certain lenses, or 99 on every single lens. So that means that the focal range of what can be in focus and how Canon can pull focus is very improved. You know, for example, if you look at some of the older Canon cameras, even the 6D Mark II, I'm pretty sure you have 45 autofocus points on there. If you look at like the SL2, I think you have something like 9. So what that means is there's gonna be more places on the sensor as far as autofocus goes to make sure the right thing is in focus. If you have less points, sometimes it might, you know, be focusing on the background when you wish it was focusing on your face, things like that. So overall, from all of our tests, the new improved dual pixel autofocus is crushing it for crispy video and great photos. Additionally, there's a whole bunch of little features they've included in the M50 that I think are really cool. One is the eye tracking. So within face tracking, you can even do eye tracking for autofocus so that you make sure that you get that really crispy photo if you're using maybe lenses that are very shallow depth of field. So we were actually testing out this camera with an adapter to some Canon L glass, and you can see from these photos here that the photos were super crispy at like aperture 1.4 or 1.6, testing out that new eye tracking autofocus, which is a super cool feature. Additionally, they've added a compressed RAW feature, which is nice if you want to shoot RAW photos but keep the file size down a little bit. I'm excited about that. And of course, this is packed with Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and NFC, including a feature that will allow you to actually transfer photos to your phone as you're taking them when you have your phone synced up with the camera. And again, I think that these Wi-Fi features are really important for shooting a lot of content on the go and then being able to share that on Instagram, social media, Facebook, things like that. And I love using the Canon Connect app to pull video clips or photos off on the go. So definitely a few things to note. All right, now let's just touch on the video capabilities of this camera. And one of the things that has been making headlines is the fact that they've included 4K in here, plus some ultra high frame rates. But here's the thing. The main feature that you'd want to pick up this camera for is solid 1080p video with really great autofocus, vlogging, YouTube, those types of things, up to 60 frames a second. From our video tests, 30 frames a second, which is just kind of standard, shooting videos like this, it looks really great. And 60 frames a second allows you to not just have crispier video footage for lots of motion and movement, but it also gives you the opportunity to slow the footage down 50% to get 2x slow motion. So I would say that should be your main focus if you wanted to pick up this camera. When it comes to the ultra high frame rate, you can actually do up to 120 frames per second, meaning you can get 4x slow motion. So we went to a skate park, got some shots, and they look amazing. The footage looks great, but it isn't 720p resolution. So I would say something you could use for some videos. You could definitely use it on Instagram videos, Facebook, use it for social media. But if it's your main feature you wanted, you might want to look for a camera that can do 120 frames a second at 1080p, because this is only 720. And then finally, the 4K itself is something that's really cool that they've included, but it definitely has some limitations and some drawbacks. The first is you can only shoot in 24 frames a second. Now, a lot of people are creating their videos in 24 frames a second. We shot this entire video in 24 frames so that we could show you the 4K footage. And that's, I think, something that is reasonable. However, a lot of people shoot in 30 frames, and so it doesn't have that. 4K is only in 24p. And additionally, 4K also adds a crop factor, which means when you actually switch it to 4K mode, if you are typically used to a really wide 1080p, if we put the 11 to 22 lens on here in this footage you see right here, it's a nice wide shot, great for vlogging, right? Well, when you click it over to 4K, look how much it crops in, right? It crops in quite a bit. And if you have a really wide lens, it's still kind of usable, but I don't know, the crop factor is pretty intense. Now, one thing I would mention is that the cool thing about this camera is that 4K would probably not be the main thing you'd want to use it for, but if there's maybe a sit-down interview you want to do, or you want a really crispy, higher resolution product photo shoot, whatever you're doing, or video shoot, you could use the 4K for a lot of things in certain scenarios. However, if it was gonna be your main 4K shooter, again, you might wanna look for a different camera. And then the last thing to know about the 4K is the fact that It actually does not have dual pixel autofocus. It goes back to a contrast-based autofocus in 4K, meaning it really does not keep autofocus as well. It kind of drifts, it hunts for autofocus. So again, for us, when using the 4K feature, we'd be using it for maybe a sit-down shoot like this, where we could set the autofocus to manual, make sure everything's crispy. But if it's on the go, I'd be sticking with 1080p and that dual pixel autofocus. All right, so right now you are seeing the 4K footage shot on the Canon M50. So we have the autofocus actually sent to manual so that it's just locked down so there's no focusing issues. We're using an 11-22 lens, which is nice and wide so that even with the crop factor, the camera is only about 4 feet away from me to get this exact shot here. And then we're using a Rode Pro microphone for the camera as well. And this is what it looks like. So I think this is a great example of how you could use this camera for 4K in certain situations, especially when locked down, whether shooting an interview or things like that. And the other nice thing about 4K footage is you don't actually have to edit in 4K. If you want to get a shot like this, you can then bring the 4K footage into a 1080p project and have 4x more resolution to crop in and out with just one angle. So again, I'd love to hear from you in the comments. What do you think about how this footage looks? Let me know. Okay, next up, let's talk about lenses for the Canon M50. Now, this is actually one of the more limited areas when it comes to Canon's mirrorless line. There certainly is not as many lenses meant for their mirrorless cameras as there are for their full-size DSLRs. However, there's a couple ways around that. Number one is I would definitely recommend the kit lens. I actually think the kit lens that comes with the camera is fantastic, 15-45. It has image stabilization built in, which definitely helps for vlogging, taking out some of the camera shake when you're walking around. And it's a great lens to give you a good focal range. Additionally, I think for most YouTube creation and content, I would just add the 11-22, that 4K clip that we just shot, we were using this lens for that because it's a little bit wider, so it helps us with that crop factor. Plus, when we're out vlogging in some of these clips that you're seeing here, that's the 11-22. It's super wide, so it's very ideal for vloggers and being able to have a kind of a wider shot. Those two lenses are a definite big recommendation, I think, if you're going to invest in a camera like this, and in particular, want to use it for vlogging. Additionally, another one of my favorite lenses for the M series is the 22mm prime lens. And the reason why is not just because it produces a really cool shot, but also because it goes to f2. If there's any downsides to the two lenses I've talked about, the kit lens and the wide angle lens, is they start at f4 on the aperture or f3.5, which just means they're really not the best for low light. This camera is great because you have an APS-C sensor, so it's a little bit better in low light because of a larger sensor. Even this test we were doing here, when we were out at the skate park as the sun was setting, it was still performing great with these lenses in low light conditions. But again, keeping in mind that a faster aperture is really gonna help if you get into a super dark situation, you know, a concert or some wedding or some party. You always wanna be thinking about, can you get a fast lens for this camera? Another lens that we've talked about here on Think Media is actually the Rokinon lens that is a 12mm 2.0 lens. So an insane lens for creating low light content. However, it has its drawbacks. It actually is manual focus, not autofocus. And if you wanna see a video about that, we'll link it up in the YouTube card as well as the description below. But saying all that when it comes to lenses, I wanna encourage you that actually just the kit lens is definitely sufficient for getting started, creating videos, shooting great photos, shooting great videos, and maybe even using for years to come. But just know that you can upgrade over time to some of these Canon lenses, and some of these are my favorite. But one other recommendation I would have is actually picking up the Canon EOS EFM adapter. Now, what this actually does is this allows you to take Canon's entire lens collection of their full-size lenses and use them on a mirrorless camera. So if you're already a Canon shooter, maybe somebody, a family member has some Canon lenses, you know, maybe you have some other access to Canon lenses, or just the simple fact that there are a lot more regular Canon lenses available, you can just add an adapter on and now use normal Canon glass. So it does make the contraption a little bit bigger and larger, but that's what I think is amazing amazing is it makes this camera very versatile, so you know that you can upgrade it and use it in different shooting scenarios. And the cool thing is a lot of times you can grab those adapters for around $100, maybe used or refurbished on Amazon, or even much cheaper. And everything we've talked about, if you want to see the prices on the specific lenses and links to this whole list, we'll throw that in the YouTube description so you can check that out. All right, so we've covered a lot so far, but next, let's actually talk about the accessories that I recommend for the Canon M50. I think that right out of the box, this is a great camera. Again, you could just hold it up and do vlogging. You could just run and gun, shoot, do photography. Very great out of the box camera, but there are a few things I think that would really level it up. And one is the fact that this camera has a microphone input built into this. This is one of the biggest advantages I feel like if you were maybe contemplating getting a point and shoot camera like the G7X Mark II or a camera like this, I feel like the fact you have interchangeable lenses, you have a mic input, yet it's still very small and portable, really gives us an advantage where if I could only bring like one camera on the road with me, I would definitely want a camera like this that gives you that flexibility. And that mic input allows you to, of course, add microphones. This is a basic Rode VideoMic Go that you can add on there to improve your audio. Now you're good to go for vlogging. We use a lot of the Rode Pro video mics, whether the Pro or the Pro Plus. All of the above would work great for enhancing your audio. And the other accessory I recommend is this Joby 3K GorillaPod. When you combo this kit up right here, even just with the kit lens, the Rode microphone, and then this GorillaPod, you have like really the ultimate vlogging setup that you can shoot with, as well as you can turn it on other people, you know, wrap this on a railing, put it on a tree, whatever you want to do, get a lot of great footage and shots. And so those are a couple accessories I'd recommend. And then the final one would be picking up probably at least one extra battery, get that LPE17, or rather LPE12 battery. And I'll put a link so you get the exact, you know, right model number in the description. And so when you get that extra battery, of course, that's gonna allow you to shoot much longer. I think that you can do around less than 300 photos off of one of the battery lives. We haven't really tested the video out fully, like trying to run it out. But again, if you plan on shooting for an hour, you wanna shoot all day, definitely get at least one or maybe two extra batteries. And that's pretty typical for video content on most cameras. So as far as my final thoughts go, I am very pumped about this camera. Keeping in mind that Canon is calling this an entry-level mirrorless camera. I think for what you get, right around $900 at the time of recording this video, here in the US with the kit lens and the camera, is a great value. Especially if you're gonna be vlogging, creating YouTube content. Now, if you were really wanting to do more pro video, have more 4K features, you want to maybe do a lot of color grading, and be shooting higher end like wedding videos or different things like that, you could get a lot of great cinematic footage out of this, but I would probably upgrade to a much more professional camera if you had some of those other needs. But if YouTube and rapid content is your priority, I think the M50 really has you covered. You know, it's also, a lot of people are asking, is it the M50 versus like the 80D or M50 versus the T7i? And I think it's the M50 for sure. I think that maybe having the lens, wider lens choice natively on those other DSLRs is nice. But in here, you're getting the same sensor, improved with the DIGIC 8 processor. You're getting all of the newest technology with the Wi-Fi, NFC, you know, the latest features. You do have a little bit of 4K support there. You still got the mic input. I just feel like it really has you covered if you're comparing it to a lot of the other cameras in the same range that are a little bit older. And if I had to choose between, say, like the 80D and the M50, and I could only bring one camera and I wanted to use it for multi-purposes while traveling, I'd be grabbing the M50 because I know I can vlog with it, I could keep it lean and mean, but then if I want to lock down in a hotel and maybe shoot some interviews for video influencers or something else, I know that I could also bring the necessary accessories and equipment to use it for that as well. Additionally, I think this is a great camera for someone who is just getting started. You know, one of the things that Canon has added to a lot of their recent cameras is a cool beginner mode. So it'll walk you through in the menu system with sort of scaled back menus to help you learn the ropes as far as taking great videos and great photos, but then you can turn that off and move more into pro mode. And as a professional shooter myself, I love the features that the Canon M50 has. I think it leans more towards that entry level, and that's why I have other cameras that I would use for, again, more higher end professional shoots. But whether you're just getting started with video, maybe you do want to use this for pro, but you understand some of the drawbacks, or if you're just in that middle range where you're like, it's got everything I need for YouTube, vlogging, travel, you know, taking great photos and also shooting great videos, I think that the M50 is definitely, in my opinion, one of the best cameras this year for YouTube and for vlogging. But that brings us to the question of the day, and that is, what do you think about the Canon M50? Maybe based on this video you just watched, or maybe some of the other reviews you've seen or testing out yourself, I'd love to hear from you in the comments section below. So thanks for checking out this video. Subscribe and hit the bell if you haven't done that yet. And if you want to see other videos in our Canon M50 series, click or tap the screen right there. For another video from Think Media, click or tap the screen right there. Until next time, Think Media is bringing you the best tips and tools for building your influence with online video. Keep crushing it, and we will talk soon.